So, this is our last day in Vegas, and everyone is getting their things together. This has been an extraordinary trip. I'm super excited to go home. That's mine.
Yeah.
Why are you trying to steal stuff?
No, I'm just...
Yeah, no, you're touching stuff.
Okay.
I'm just messing with him. We have beautiful Teresa.
Hi.
Oh, love her so much.
Oh, look at her.
We have Rohan, who just learned my name today. Don't make no sense. I'm not even going to hug him. Doesn't make sense. How you in the house with somebody for 5 days, don't know their name?
I always call
just
Sharifa.
Stop.
Look here.
Did you already say, he called me Sharifa. I'm highly offended. That's Sharifa right there. No, don't call me nothing. Don't call me nothing. So we pretty much packed up. I'm so going to miss this trip or this room. The beds are super comfortable. It's going to be a bittersweet goodbye. So next year, my goal is to walk across the stage, become an SMD, which means Senior Marketing Director. That is my goal, to be able to help as many people as possible, as well as change my last name forever. That is my goal. I have a lot of work to do. I have a lot of people to help. I have a lot of people to talk to. I have a big event going on August the 19th from 12 to 2. And it will primarily deal with hairstylists, salon owners, merchants who deal with hair, because we have a lot of businesses out there. Hair is $1.2 trillion business. There's a lot of money pertaining to hair. But how many of those millions are we seeing? So that's what I want to get down to the bottom of and kind of talk about the company, what it is that we have to offer, how we can help them, help us, help them type of thing. And I'm super excited. I'm fired up. I'm just excited for what's to come. I will most definitely push myself as hard as I possibly can, because one thing I do have is personality and character. Goes a long way. Personality and character goes a long way. I have no problem with talking to people, as you guys can see from my videos. I talk to everybody, anybody. I don't care what your status is. I don't care if you have a suit on. I don't care if you have shorts on. I don't care. So I have that as my advantage, because a lot of people don't know how to do that, you know. The other day we played a game, and this goes out to the people who have a hard time talking to people. So me and my team, we played a game to see how many compliments we could give, right? So we walked down to MGM, and whoever walked by, we said something nice to them. For example, hey, I like your dress. It's really pretty. Oh my God, you're so handsome. I'm really good at that. I typically give men compliments, and I'll say, oh wow, you're very handsome, because a lot of men don't get compliments like that. So when they do get compliments, they are like, you should see their face light up. And they're like, oh, thank you. Because they're not used to women complimenting them. Yes, I'm in here. Minding my own business. Okay, back to what I'm saying. So that is for those of you who are not comfortable with talking to strangers, just start out as making it a game and just compliment. You know, nice dress. I love that blouse. Where did you get it from? And then when you do that, you graduate to, hi, I like that dress. Where did you get it from? And then you go into, may I ask you, what is it that you do? Why you have such an amazing personality? You know, we're looking for good people. And then you go into the conversation, which is the script. You go into the prospecting script. Everyone has different ways of prospect. Mine is compliments. I like to make people smile. As long as I can get a smile out of them, I can get a number. And that's my strategy. So my goal is to go out there and dominate. Or you can also say, hey, would you like to make extra money? You know, And then they'll be kind of curious. I'll also say our expansion department right now, they're looking for good people. And they said if I ever run into anyone, you know, to give them their number. Can I get your name and number? I'll have someone at the office give you a call. And then I'll open up a dialogue that way. So prospecting is really my thing. The thing that got me with the convention is the people who are dominating, like 800 prospects. I'm like, what the? Oh my God, I was so mad at myself. You guys, you know, it was really inspiring, but it was also like, I know how to prospect. So now I'm so extra. I'm going to push harder to prospect and make it my business to get as many names and numbers in a day. That is my goal. I am going to be the number one prospector. God has already put it out there. I've already put it out there. I manifested 100 recruits a month. That is my goal. My short-term goal, I'm working on that. But my goal is to get 100 recruits a day. And also running through the system, the 7-day standard, to be able to properly get them through the 7-day standard. That's something that I struggle with. I rely a lot on my team. I need to stop doing that. I need to just go ahead, be the leader that I am, and get them through the 7-day standard with no problems. So I'm going to push myself and challenge myself to make that happen. I have about 3 people right now who I need to get through licensing. So I'm going to be dominant on, hey, you need to get your licensing if you want to get paid. We need to get your licensing. You need to get your licensing. And I need to be dominant with that. And not be pushy, but the urgency. Make it an urgency that you must and you have to get your license. Currently, right now, I have 5 licensed agents. It's not a lot, I know. I should have way more than that. But you know what? Today is a new day, a new beginning, 2019. Y'all gonna see my name in lights, Earlene Gray. Remember this name, Earlene Gray. Mario Bayola is one of my favorite speakers, next to Ed Mylett and Paul Hart. Of course, Eric Olson, MVP, back to back. You already know, MVP, Team Tentacle. Love you guys. I'm from Team Vertex. I am from Anthony Resendez's office, one of the top coaches, period. Awesome. So I have one of the best trainers in the best office in Sacramento, and we are going to dominate, and we're ready. We're fired up, and I'm ready to make this happen. I'm super excited. I know I'm just so extra with it, but I am. Everything about this trip, I'm mad it's over. It went by so fast. I tried to take it all in and just breathe. Another thing I liked is the fact that he stated, you have to be crazy. And I don't think nobody is crazy as me, in a good way. I don't take me as a man, but I'm a little special. And it's okay, because I'm different. I'm not riding a herd. I'm not a sheep. I'm just me. And I'm going to be me to the day I die. And I'm going to dominate this business. And my goal is to be one of the top African Americans in this business, one of the best. So, all you people out there who got your $100,000 ring, $200,000 ring, $300,000, blah, 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 I'm coming for your title, okay? I'm coming. I'm coming to take what's mine. You're going to see me on stage. You're like, that girl did a whole rant about WFG. Yes, I did. I did a whole rant about WFG because I am going to be on the top. Earlene Gray. Say it again. Earlene Gray. Ooh, that sounds good. I hear the cheers. I hear it. It's there. It's just for me to go out and take it and grab and take what's mine. Literally. So, you guys have a blessed day. I'm so excited. Okay, don't yell. I'm trying to be humble and quiet. But I have this ball of fire in my stomach. And I want to yell and scream and run and just be crazy, but I'm trying to contain her because she a little special too. So I have to coach myself a lot on calming down, but I'm ready. I'll be on stage with my name and lights. And y'all gonna know it's me because I'm gonna act a fool. I'm not gonna do the traditional like walk, oh, and wave, oh, hey. No, I'm gonna be extra. Because that's me. Okay, you guys, till next time. WFG MVP. We are leaving our beautiful room. Hello. I know. If I fall on this floor, there's a problem. Because it's not even a floor you fall on.
Wait a minute. Right on the fourth floor. What are we doing on the fourth floor?
Hi, how are you doing?
Door's closing. I'm ready to go. I'm so tired.
We're almost there.
First floor.
This is our floor.
Red floor. Come on. Get the fuck in.
You know, girl. Smell good.
Okay, who did tell me
that? No.
Is he out here?
No.
Is he coming in the front? Because I need a cup of coffee.
Bye, girl.
Let me get your number. Oh, thank you so much. You already got your coffee? That was fast. I never see you move that fast. Look at Sharifa getting her daily coffee that she shouldn't even be drinking, but that's another story. We're not going to talk about that. Do I want French vanilla or do I want mocha? Macchiato. You don't need all that cream either. See, what would she do if I wasn't around? Probably be at peace.
I'm about to say, live my
own fucking
life. I would never
want
to lose you, Earlene Gray.
Oh, say my name again.
Earlene Gray.
Say it again, girl.
Earlene Gray.
My memory and my phone is the business. We coming right now.
Okay, because I already paid for it. Let's go. Yeah, I'm going to get
charged
another day.
Oh, no. We might as well drive this sack. Oh, no, because we already have our airplane ticket. Damn, that wouldn't make sense. Oh, this thing is hot. Oh, shoot. Okay.
You know, you couldn't wait until we got to the airport to get coffee?
Yeah, but it's cheaper.
Exactly.
This way. We're on our way on the shuttle. We just turned in a rental car. Shuttle. It's still our organs.
Make sure you have the right bags.
Watch that movie too.
We hope you enjoyed your stay here.
That's why I don't want to know where it's called.
Please come back and see us again soon.
Thank you for having us. We so appreciate it.
Hey, can you put my black bag on the suitcase?
We are now arriving at Terminal 1. For the safety of yourself and other passengers, we ask that you please remain seated while the bus is in motion. If you are flying,
oh my gosh. Who is this? Oh. That tired face. Stuff is heavy. Get it together. Vegas, it was fun. Well, you know, we're still here. So I had a beginning, a middle, and an end. So good. Well, it's a Monday, so it might not be that bad. Talent is so shaky. Well, I'm gonna take my hustle to the old town.
Before we check in, can we do self-service?
Yeah, so you're gonna get the bags in first and then come back to drop off your bags.
Well, I mean, I already checked this in.
Yeah, we can see the tag.
So we need tags for all of these that we have in our hands?
No, just that.
Oh, okay. They'll let you carry this one? It's liquid?
I don't know. They may
have check this one?
No, check.
Oh.
Is there liquid in here?
It's liquid right here. They're not going to let you take this on there. Well, huh? Are they going to let you take this
one? It's too late to check in for your flight.
Huh?
At kiosk.
Check in for your flight.
What time is
your flight?
2:35.
We get reported 2:35.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, before you pass in.
Okay, I'll call
you. She's back.
Looking on her email.
Okay. I'm trying to check. If it's for 2:35,
you
definitely
here on time. Uh-huh. We way before our time. I have a question. Will I be able to carry this on? It is only one. So how do I do this? She said only one. So how would I be able to check this in?
Well, maybe do all of them have a bag already?
We just have like food.
We only have one bag. One bag charging is $65.
Really? Sharifa, can I put this in your...
I have to see how much my bag weighs.
Okay.
You already checked
in. Yeah, we just did 10.
Looks good.
I don't take care of your bag. It's just concerning.
Yeah, you're allowed
one. No, overweight?
The first one.
We don't know yet. Yeah, we have to weigh it.
It's like
we
have to make
first
before.
Each shoe
is
$3.
It's
going to charge more.
It's going to charge more at the counter.
No, it's not worth
it. Oh.
They charge me an extra $50-some
at the counter?
Yeah.
I mean, if that was
the only thing. It was $66, but I already paid for the bag.
Today or tomorrow?
The $40-some was like...
There, go down there, Sharifa. A question, so will we better take this on the airplane?
Yeah, you can take anything, but you can't take any liquids.
Okay, so we have
stand
to...
Stand in line, or where are we going next?
We're going to have to toss this, Rohan. Huh? We're going to have to toss this.
I'm putting this to the head.
She said you can't bring liquids on.
You put it in your suitcase, but you can't take liquids past TSA.
Yep.
Yeah.
No, I think my bag is... We got to weigh it first.
Okay.
Weigh it right here. Yeah.
Because I don't want you to charge extra. That thing looks kind of heavy. Oh, it's under.
About 10 pounds.
Look, people. This is what Erlene has to do.
It's not even on. Is it on?
Oh, yeah. Sure is.
So do it like this?
One? No.
Hey, thank you, girl.
There's more. How come it only gave us one boarding pass? It's four of us.
Okay.
Well, can't I use the other one on my phone?
Yeah, so I'll just have
one. Okay, I can use one on my phone. Sure you
will. This is what happens when you overpack. Have issues. Yeah, I told him. You can't take the liquid song. What did Roland carry? Did he carry anything?
That's what I'm gonna ask. Will they let me go with 42 pounds? 41?
Yeah, I do. It's a, I got an email. She said it's how I can do it, so.
Just have one big ass bag.
Do it with a smile.
Now I gotta put my purse inside that bag just to have one bag.
Yeah. At least we got it together. Teresa, you have to put the gray bag in there. What y'all gonna do with the food? I'm glad we came early. Do I need one? Let me put this right here. They're getting it together. Do I need a tag? No. Okay.
Let me forward this to your email so you can pull it up.
Okay.
Your boarding pass.
So I need to show it to him? I need to show it to him.
I'm going to forward this to your email. What is your...
Erlene, E-R-L-I-N-E. Gray. Erlene.gray.yahoo.com.
Yeah, so pull it up.
Okay.
What gate? 814.
Man, seriously.
And if we needed an extra bag, I would have gotten the Victoria's Secret bag out of the suitcase if we needed it.
I see. You know what? This addiction you got going on needs to stop. I wonder if I could tie this around here. My pants around my neck. And tie it. No. Mm-hmm. Oh, Lord. They trying to have fun with the wheelchairs. I'm not getting pushed. I'm walking to the end. I'm like, I'm walking to the end. When I drop, I'm going to be walking when I drop.
Both sides, left and right. Both sides.
Oh, sorry. So I need to pull up my... Look at that shiny forehead.
Oh, shiny forehead like a diamond.
I choose to be happy. I want it. So Sharifa got tapped down, pat down because I'm like, go get that old man.
Yes.
Y'all punked me out my change that was on the ground that y'all didn't even pay attention to.
Snooze, you lose. That's for gambling.
Look at this.
You're wrong, I'm going half.
Y'all got two quarters to play with each.
Yes.
Whoa, don't spin it all in one place.
That's gonna be the lucky quarter.
The dollar machine.
About to hit a million.
That, no. If you hit a million, we're going back.
Me and my sister were sitting there. We had just sat down. We just sat down. Hit 75 cents, won 3 grand.
Exactly. Wow.
Yeah, that's what's about to happen in here.
Yeah, because y'all was hitting them up on that blackjack. You made me money. That you did do. I had $11. She compound my money, boy. Solid 20 and some change, boy. I was like, Teresa is bomb. We need to plan a trip to Thunder Valley. I don't really like to gamble. I'll take $20 and gamble it. Uh-huh. Oh, okay. We gotta go to the office at 7, right?
Six. I wasn't at convention.
It does not matter. So what? You still on our team. Stop it. Let's go. Y'all ready? You are a part of the team, girl. Quit playing. See, this is how you do a 360 degree. See, you get the whole footage. 360 degree. Cool, huh? You know what? Shut up. They actually do have a camera that does that. You know what? You get on my nerves. You know what? That's why I'm putting the most embarrassing pictures of you out. Yeah, you're so used to it. You don't even trip no more.
No, I don't. I'm like, all the ones that I didn't post on Facebook, you posted them in that video. I was like, oh my God. Jesus.
I already posted it. It's already out there.
I should have erased that shit. And I looked at the video, I said, okay.
You look good. You look good, you eat good, you smell good. She ain't fat, bruh. She just a little thick. Anything a skinny girl can do. You always hungry. I swear you can't eat.
I know.
I can't eat any. I have you on video saying it. I'm going to show you it, what you said. Before and after.
No, no, no. Restaurants. Food.
Oh, food. Footage. Are we in the A gate?
Yeah.
Okay, then let's go A gate.
Shouldn't we go towards our flight, or?
Yeah, that's where we're going.
Okay.
I am not going back through.
Bags down.
Yeah. I am not going back through the TSA.
It wasn't even bad, like everyone makes it seem. Like, it wasn't bad. I don't think
so. Double down. I like double down.
But she got the feeling. Baby, I just got the feeling. You looking real cute. I like that orange. She on the phone. She's on her phone, but she looks super cute though. With her orange on. The orange is super cute. Man, it's shaky footage. Baby. I got it. You didn't see that.
Yes, he did.
He did not see that.
You know he did.
He didn't see it. He just see my beautiful smile. He's like, dang, that girl got a beautiful smile. He got a beautiful smile too.
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does. Area 51, Mental Reality. Go over there if you want to. Welcome to Las Vegas, USO. Feed your curiosity. Bye-bye, Las Vegas. There go our flight. Spirit is waiting for us. He want to proudly wear his hat, Trump 2020. He waiting for somebody to say something, his little Trump 2020 hat on.
Okay, so we have three lounge.
We need to sit our bags down somewhere, because this stuff is heavy. Oh, excuse me. Starbucks. Starbucks always has a line. Morning, noon, or night. Smoking permitted. That's the lung cancer room right there.
That's the room that people go to de-stress.
And smoke and play games. You could buy Trojans here. We had the same thought. That's the first thing.
That's all.
Like, why do they have condoms at the airport? What's really going on at this airport? Oh my goodness. Oh, she looks so beautiful.
The biggest little city.
Where are you again? Let's see
if I'm gonna see what I'm buying in the on the airplane.
Okay, they have
Moe's. Southwest Grill. Where's the ATM at? I know they're in here. It does. We believe every hour should be happy hour. That's what I'm talking about.
A11, they're right back there.
That's what I'm doing. A11 over here. Over here. And my arm is hurting too. Yeah. As long as somebody take my selfie stick in my phone, I'm not tripping. You have all this stuff. Not my phone. I have important stuff on this phone. All my business and everything. I guess we'll put it right there. No, that's 12.
Or we have a couple seats here.
Right.
You're gonna need a plug.
Oh, there's plugs right there. Oh, that's dope. What? Nobody gonna steal your little snacks. I know. It is an airport. It could have been a bomb. Oh, don't use that word at the airport.
I know.
I stopped myself. It could have been a... Tackle me down. Some more stuff. We set it down.
Right there.
Where the plug
where is. Where you see the blue seats? Okay. Oh, I'm leaving.
Who said that?
I'm good.
Who did it say?
When? You're not supposed to. Walk away now. Walk away. I need an ATM. Vegas. What was your favorite part?
Was the pool. And
the three and a half, 4 feet in pool.
Right. You understand?
How tall are you again?
I was 5 foot up. Well,
no, how tall are you?
I'm 6'8". So yeah. I was 4'8" out of the pool.
Yeah, so he tried to swim, but he's super duper tall, standing in the water. I'm just be excited when this ship, when this is over. I'm ready to go home.
We'll be home in like 30 minutes.
It's taking too long. My nerves is bad. I'm ready to go home. I'm sitting between people. I can't move. Like, at least yesterday, I was able to put my foot out and, like, move around, but I feel like a little kid. Strapped in.
You're funny.
No, I'm serious. I'm gonna keep my eyes.
You got something?
Thank you, sir. So
what was your best part of Vegas?
I loved all of it. I loved the room. I loved the event. I loved the speakers. Everything. I didn't have no bad moments. Except for the turbulence of leaving. That I didn't like. And luckily nobody had a camera because I look like a damn fool. I don't like. And another thing, she wants to get dropped out of the air. What is it called?
I fly.
So she wants me to fall and then some wind or air is.
The air lifts you up.
Okay.
And you're suspended.
Yeah. So I asked her, I said, is it a guarantee that the machine won't break and then I'll just fall to my death on the ground? And what did you say?
No, I guarantee it.
How do you guarantee something like that?
Because they take all of the safety precautions.
No.
You are not going to fall to your death.
She cannot guarantee that. Not only that, no zip lining, no falling out of airplanes, no falling out the air. I'm scared of heights. Like looking out the window, because it's beautiful. I'm
in and looking out the window at 30,000 feet up in the air.
It's beautiful.
Look at this.
No,
then I had a detour, and then you had to wait in the airport how long?
Probably 2 hours.
And then you had to board another airplane.
Yes, to get to my destination. But the weather was bad, so we had
so
we
why
had
would you fly in bad weather?
There's nothing you can do.
So you're a thrill seeker.
No.
You like to be thrilled.
No. I had to get back to Atlanta.
It was that
critical, yes.
Okay. So you couldn't, like...
Wait another day?
Okay.
What level are you on, Teresa? Which one are you playing?
Candy Crush.
I know, but which one?
I hate Candy Crush.
Saga,
I think I'm the only person who do not do Candy Crush.
I think it's,
I really don't... There's not enough thought into Candy Crush. You just... colors around. I don't like games like that.
Damn.
Oh my god, you don't see me. How many hours is it from Jamaica to Sacramento?
I didn't come straight to Sacramento. I came to Frisco from Panama.
Panama? How many hours is that? Three hours?
45 minutes.
Oh, okay, that's not bad. So when are we going to Jamaica?
So what if we have to go during a storm?
We're not going through a storm.
In SMB.
We're not going through a storm.
When we hit SMB.
No, I get it. But what I'm saying is, she said, what if we have to go through a storm? And I said, we're not going through a storm.
So a freak storm.
Is Spirit is always looking for ways to save you money in your air travels, and we call that Morgo. Another way that we provide Morgo is by surprising one lucky guest on every flight with a voucher of 5,000 free miles, which is equivalent to a round trip ticket based on where he chose to travel on Spirit Airlines. In order for us to know who that lucky guest is, we need everyone to place down your tray table. If you happen to find a yellow and white placard that says you're sitting in the lucky seat or you're the lucky winner, please press your flight attendant call button.
I never win anything.
It's our opportunity to win 5,000 free miles, which is equivalent to a round trip ticket. If you don't claim your prize, I'll take it.
Oh, 5,000 free miles.
That person must be sleeping.
No, that person didn't come on the flight. Somebody else did not. It's an empty seat.
Here you go, honey. You can throw up in there.
Oh, I'm like, you won? You know what? You play too much. This is what she had
on. I suggest sitting in 13B as a boy, whether you are awake or not. You've won 5,000 free miles.
Wow.
Congratulations.
That's dope. So that means they can go from here to Jamaica.
I don't think this plane goes to Jamaica.
Oh. From here to LA?
Probably.
Where's Montego Bay?
Montego Bay.
I want to go to Kingston. I want to go to the club where they dance and jump on top of each other.
Exactly.
Yeah, I know, in the dirt. They so gutter with it. I want to see it.
During Carnival.
And for those of you who did not have the opportunity to earn 5,000 from us, it's okay. No need to be jealous or be a hater.
Oh.
We do have opportunity for you to earn 3 miles as well. That's why we want to share a special and limited time offer for the Spirit MasterCard. If you apply in flight today, you will receive 35,000 bonus miles after your first purchase. Meaning if you go to a local gas station to buy a bag of gum or a bottle of water for $3, it'll start off your 35,000 bonus miles. That is 15,000 more miles than our usual offer of 20,000. And if that's not enough, as a Spirit MasterCard holder, you'll enjoy the exclusive perks, such as Zone 2 priority boarding, meaning you get to skip everybody else in the line and board first.
Yeah.
That's 2 miles for every dollar you spend to earn every purchase. Plus, redeeming all these miles has never been easier thanks to the redemption level that starts as low as 2,500 miles. And taxes and fees from just $6 for a one-way off-peak flight based on availability. Those of you who decide to apply today and turn in the application to one of the flight attendants will add an additional 1,000 bonus miles in there for you. So therefore, if you get approved, you'll end up with 36,000 bonus miles, which is equivalent to 7 or 8 round-trip tickets based on where you choose to travel on Spirit Airlines. If you happen to not get approved for the application, it's okay. You still get to keep the 1,000 bonus free mile with you today. So we're going to be walking down the cabin. And if you're interested, please let us know.
So we got to fill out
our application.
And they give you 1,000 miles. Like I did when we came in. I might do it again. Just get another 1,000 miles.
Yeah, that's
going to
be nice.
What?
I just want to go home.
I don't care about their miles.
All my stuff is still this old this year.
Sorry. Did I hurt you?
No, it's okay.
That's better.
Captain has turned on the seatbelt sign. If you are up and about the cabin, please return to your seat and fasten your seatbelt. Those of you that are presently seated, please be sure that your seatbelts are securely fastened. It is for your safety and the safety of those around you. Thank you.
Okay, you guys.
Yes.
This is Hi, what guys. Happened.
Oh, okay.
Oh, where's my charger?
Is this yours?
Yes, okay. That is. Let me see the thing. So let me tell you guys what just happened. This heifer winch. Trying to irk my whole nerves. No. We're no longer friends anymore. I don't like her anymore. And I'm never, ever, ever, ever riding with her ever again. Ever. Never, ever.
Yes,
never.
Is.
No. I don't like her.
Don't let her lie.
She whispered in my ear, the plane is going down. The plane is going down. What the hell? I said, who are you? You're the devil. Who does that to somebody? Who? It's going down. I said, I'm just going to pretend like it's a bus. She's going to say the wheels on the bus go round and round off the cliff or somewhere. Who does that to somebody? Like, I don't even know who she is anymore. I don't know who she is at all. I'm so cool on her. I don't like her anymore. And I'm never, ever sitting by her on an airplane ever again.
Oh, well.
Ever. Ever.
I guess I'm flying by myself.
Yep.
All right. Then I'm getting away from you. As
my
of
nerves
now.
Is...
Goodbye.
Bye? I don't want to be your friend anymore anyway. Be my own friend. Me, myself, and I is all I got in the end. That's what I found out. And I ain't no need to cry. Because now on, I'm going to be my own best friend. Period. Just don't make no dang sense. Crazy. So I just decided Jamaica trip. We getting on the water. I'm not flying all them hours on no airplane. No, I'm getting on the water because
hold on. If you're going to Jamaica,
because I'd rather be on a ship. Yes.
If you're going to Jamaica by boat, you have to fly into Florida.
Why we can't drive to Florida?
You want to be in a car for 4 days?
It's like 4 days to get to Florida.
Yes.
Man, why everything so long?
Cause we're on West Coast, they on East Coast.
Yeah, I don't want to drive no 4 days.
Then suck it up, buddy.
Let me think. What else could we do?
Suck it up, buttercup.
There has to be another way.
No, either fly, drive, or you know what? You can take a bus. It'll take you like 10 days to get there.
Ladies and gentlemen,
no, that
due to the summer heat, we're gonna ask for all of you to please open your air vents that are above your head. And passengers that are sitting next to a window, please close your window shades in order to maintain all of us cool while we're in the aircraft as the jet bridge approaches.
How hot Thank is you. It in Sacramento? I'm ready to get off this. Did I undo my seatbelt? Sorry, mom. Shut up, bro. Nothing.
Excuse me. Don't yell at him like that.
No, he's being funny. He's like, if you can't get up.
Don't be mean like that.
No. Thank
Here,
you.
Here, Miss Non-Friend.
She's so sweet.
Watch your head. Don't let these big puppies...
That is super good.
That's his big boo.
You and that stylist. That's the highlight of her day. Her week. WFG stylist.
Oh my god, the Dow dropped another 400 points.
Did it? That means a lot of people lost a lot of money.
Jesus.
So, my brother-in-law may be hating life right now. Because he doesn't have an index account.
Cool. So he just lost a lot of money. Listen. Not only that, the people retirement. They just lost a lot of their retirement money.
No, this is 7 plus 4. This is now 1,100.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. No, plus another 3. So that's 1,400 points in a week.
So tell the people out there what that means.
That means if your retirement is in a variable account, which is the stock market, you're screwed.
Yep. That's what it means.
That means all the money that have been compounding that you think compounding, you just lost.
Yep.
And please don't be in your 50s and 60s because you're really fucked up then.
Did you really use a curse word?
Yes, I did.
Ooh, she's angry.
Is that serious?
No, I know.
It's very serious. It's
especially when we're trying to advise people that if you're in variable, get fixed, indexed, because that's the only way to preserve your money and your future.
Let me call Brenda. Nobody wants to listen.
Yep. It isn't like we do this for our health.
I'm trying to sit with Vanessa, Brenda. Come on, people, let's go. I got my nerves. I think I'm gonna help people up. What happened?
His neck hurts.
Oh, I can't move anymore.
You want me to sit down and you let him out?
Yeah. Hold on, we're about to Sharifa is gonna sit down so he can get out. I'll sit on your page so I can share.
Well, honey, I'm sorry. But even midgets need planes.
Come on, Rohan. No, put your neck right there.
Move out. You're so stupid. Move out.
Flight attendants, please disarm doors for arrival. Cross check and alcohol.
That did sound weird when I said it, but it's true. He got stick his head right there. Bam. It sucks being tall.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't. It does when you're on an airplane and you're trying to walk down a hallway at the Tropicana and you have to bend down.
Oh, did anybody catch that?
I did. Oh. No, I did.
Ladies and gentlemen, please collect your luggage at carousel number 3. Once again, please collect all your luggage at carousel number 3. Have a nice day.
You did?
Yes, I recorded that. See, aren't you happy to be around people like me? I do.
Recording rolling balls.
Rolling balls? I did not. I
took a picture of his bottom. I really couldn't stop laughing.
His bottom how?
Because if he didn't realize what was happening.
Only when I knew it, because Teresa was like dying laughing. She was like tickle king. She had this eerie witch laugh.
I'm sorry. I got that from my mom.
Like she was on a broomstick flying through the air after she didn't kill Dorothy.
Are you serious?
That's how Dorothy laughed on The Wizard of Oz. It sounded just like her.
Dorothy is
The witch.
Girl.
The witch that got
the house Wicked Witch. And,
yeah, you sounded like the Wicked Witch of the East. And it was eerie and loud. I let Sharifa listen to it.
I was
dying laughing. I was like, what did I miss? I'm glad I was recording.
Oh my God.
I wasn't watching. It was super funny. That was funny.
Yeah, come over here and just sit right there.
I told him to put his neck right there.
Until it starts moving. That way your neck and your back won't hurt.
My neck and my back. You might just sit down then.
Sit down?
Mm-hmm.
So that's time in Jamaica right now?
What time? No, I said it back.
You already wrote that we're going to wait till we get out.
No, we
got to
wait till we get our bags.
Oh, yeah. I have my bag.
You can't. No, I'm not sorry.
Yeah, I can't what?
Lift up the handle.
Who, me?
No, the side handle on the thing.
This has been a wonderful weekend. I had so much fun.
Bless you.
Just think if you guys didn't come with me, you guys would be so boring and dry.
So you're the
wife? I am the wife. Okay. You guys are dry and boring.
Really?
Yes, all y'all. They're all just dry.
Well, you have evidence on your phone. So
yeah, I do.
You video everything.
I do. I do everything. So you pass gas, I'll have it on camera. So everybody can be
dang. Dang.
I record everything. Because you never know what might happen. Like if you jump out the pool and your box is falling out.
Oh, man, it's going to be triple digits for the next couple of days.
Go ahead.
Yes, it is, Colin.
Go ahead, you guys. You're welcome.
All right.
I'm good. Aren't you aggressive, Teresa?
Okay.
Go ahead, sweetie.
Nick, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm great.
How was your flight?
Scary. It was okay. I was right next to the devil, so I wasn't able to enjoy it the way I wanted to. I was not screaming. I was just praying. I pray in the morning and at night.
Someone left the bag of this.
Yeah.
Okay,
thank you. Bye.
Yes.
Ooh. Hi. Oh my gosh, it's hot.
It is hot.
It's hotter out here than it was in Vegas. Well, probably not. Because right now Vegas is probably burning up. But maybe it's just
not anymore.
I don't know what that means.
Whatever that means.
I don't even want to ask what that means.
Meaning that everybody got to look up to me.
Oh.
Okay. So are you the only one in your family?
No.
Oh.
How you doing?
I'm the third of six.
And he's tall like you?
No, he's 6'4". 6'4", 6'3", 6'1".
So happy to be back in Sacramento. This thing is heavy.
Okay, you mean that?
Yeah. I wouldn't record you telling it. What'd you say? What did you say?
Jesus.
Oh, we're almost home. Well, actually, we have to go to the office. So we're not almost home. We have a meeting after Vegas. Ooh, the rabbit. So, tour guide, what does the rabbit represent? Hopper. I looked it up. I don't remember. That's dope, whoever made that, though. That's super cool. Disaster recovery crowd.
Oh, look at the horses.
Oh, a giant toilet suitcase. Right there, he's standing on.
Why did she come and get me?
Well, she's waiting on her ride.
Why did she come and get me?
Okay. That is so cool. Embark Redlands. Vegas was so much liver. Their airport was super liver.
Please keep all bags.
Oh, already.